If we try to find the helix nebula, is it there? Oh yes, it's kind of toward the center.
What we're looking at now is nearly 30 million times as far away as Mars.
Astrophysicist Munazza Alam is in Cambridge, Massachusetts, searching the stars for distant planets. Our solar system consists of a star, known as the Sun, and eight planets. These planets are held in orbit around the Sun by its gravitational pull. Planets found outside of our solar system are known as exoplanets. And these are what Munazza is searching for. To find them, Munazza needs a telescope, and a powerful one at that. Here at Harvard University, she's got one, the Clay Telescope.
This is an advanced telescope, and we use a computer to control where it points. It has attached to it something that's very similar to a camera. So when we point the telescope to whatever we're interested in observing, the telescope will start to collect the light into this device. And we can use that light that we collect to take a picture of what the telescope is looking at.
Just as gravity causes our Earth to revolve around the Sun, gravity's pull also causes other planets to revolve around their host stars. So, by watching stars, we can discover other planets. To find these exoplanets, Munazza uses an advanced technique called the transit method. It involves looking for periodic changes in a star's brightness due to an orbiting exoplanet passing in front of, or as astronomers call it, transiting its star.
So if we have our star and we have a planet passing in front of it, when the planet is on this side of the star, we just observe the light from the star. But when the planet is in front of the star, then it blocks a portion of the light, and that causes this dip in the brightness of the star. And then when it passes, it again restores the brightness of the star. This dip tells us the size of the planet.
By measuring a star's temporary dimming, Munazza can estimate everything from the size of an exoplanet to its temperature.
We have discovered exoplanets that are similar to our own solar system's Jupiter, but very close in, so they're hot. We've discovered icy worlds, rocky worlds, and we've even discovered that exoplanets have atmospheres like our own Earth.
But for Munazza, finding exoplanets isn't enough. She's looking for an Earth twin.
I want to find a world that has an ocean, ice caps, or even life.
In order to identify such a planet, we would need to search for biosignatures or the fingerprints of life. We think these could be oxygen, ozone, or methane, depending on what we see in our Earth's atmosphere. But who knows what the biosignatures could be on other planets, depending on what the life forms are like.
Munazza hasn't found an Earth twin yet, but she's optimistic.
There are thousands of planets out there waiting to be discovered, but they're hidden among the vastness of the universe.
So she's looking for more help.
The world needs more astronomers so that we can work together collectively to understand our place on Earth and the universe. My job is amazing. As an astronomer, I get to visit telescopes at interesting locations like deserts and mountaintops, and I get to explore the universe. If you're interested in becoming an astronomer, I'd suggest being curious. Ask questions, ask why, and look up at the night sky.